afternoon, and thank you all for coming on short notice. I'm here today to reaffirm the Spokane Police Division's commitment to and support of the sexual assault investigation being led by the Spokane County Sheriff's Office. The allegations being investigated by the Sheriff's Office are very disturbing, and we take them very seriously. We will continue to provide whatever level of cooperation and support is necessary to the Sheriff's Office to allow the investigation to play out under the independent agency. This includes involving the FBI if deemed necessary by the Sheriff's Office. Our sole focus needs to be on investigating the allegations and the well-being of the female officer. I have complete confidence in the investigative process, both the criminal investigation being led by the Sheriff's Office and the internal investigation that Spokane Police Chief Rick DeBrow has initiated. I assure you that any of the allegations being investigated, if proven, will be dealt with swiftly. We hold our police officers to the highest standard of conduct, and anything less will not be tolerated. At this time, I will turn it over to Sheriff Ozzy Knezovich, followed by Chief DeBrow.
Thank you, Mayor. I want to reiterate what the Mayor had to say as far as our cooperation and working together. The Spokane County Sheriff's Office, in coordination with the Spokane Police Department, have been working on this issue for the last 4 days. The Spokane Police Department's command staff has been nothing but above board and helpful in this investigation. I'd also like to point out that it is a mere fraction of people that we're talking about their conduct. 99.9% of the Spokane Police Department does their job and does it very well and with honor. It's sad that you have these type of situations that actually tarnish the badge for everyone that wears a badge. We are going to continue to deal with this matter. We have split these two cases, one into a sexual assault investigation, the other one into a look at the leak of information to the suspect. Right now, they're both ongoing investigations, so I won't be going in depth on either one of those. But I want to reassure the public that the Spokane County Sheriff's Office and the Spokane Police Department are in full cooperation, and we both find these allegations to be disheartening, and we take them very serious. Chief.
Thanks, Sheriff. I can't add much to what either the mayor or Sheriff Knezovich said, other than to reiterate the fact that we are working collaboratively. The Spokane Police Division and I take the allegations extremely seriously, but that's what they are at this point. They're allegations. We're not trying anybody in the media. These persons involved have a right to due process, and we will let the investigation go through its proper stages, and the facts will speak to themselves. I have an expectation that my officers will cooperate fully, and we are cooperating fully, and I have the utmost in confidence in Sheriff Knezovich's organization and the abilities of his investigative team to do a fair, thorough, and impartial investigation, and we'll have to see what facts are revealed during that investigation. Thank you.
Thank you for being with us today, and we'll take any few questions.
Why did you wait till now to say something? We haven't heard from you since the beginning.
Actually, you have. I've released a statement, and I also have the confidence in the independent investigation being done by the sheriff, and that is the normal practice to allow the investigating organization to brief the public as necessary.
Was there any influence by City Hall on this investigation, specifically calling it a sexual assault?
No.
There have been words exchanged between the sheriff and your city administrator.
We're here to talk about an investigation that is between that the sheriff is conducting, and as he explained them, there's two investigations, and we'll let the facts play out as they may.
No comment, though. That was a pretty heavy.
This is an active investigation. It would not be prudent for me to have comments on it. It is. We'll let the facts play out where they are.
So just to be clear, Teresa Saunders did not ask that sexual assault not be used in the press release.
That is what her statements are, and yes, that is correct. Thank you very much.
Another question on the culture audit. I know you called me and left a message. Are you regretting now not doing a culture audit in the police department?
We are doing, as I commented, this is about the investigations that are in front of us, the cultural audit. We've been working very closely with the Department of Justice over the last several months to determine a avenue to do that. They have not been able to provide that, and that's why it was yesterday that I announced the team that will be coming together from our community to answer four questions, and that being one of them, to facilitate the process to identify the technique, the tools, the modality by which we would do a cultural audit.
Do you think this is going to have any effect on that investigation by the Department of Justice into the Spokane Police Department?
That would be for the Department of Justice to comment on.
How many police officers were at the party, Chief or Sheriff?
We're still in the process of rounding those names up and interviewing people, so I can't give you a total of that quite as yet.
A handful, 10, 20, 50?
Very few, from what I understand.
So less than five, maybe?
Somewhere around that neighbor, but don't hold me to that because I don't have that number down quite yet.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.